Hello, I'm Clint Dyer, Deputy Artistic Director of the National Theatre, and I'm happy to welcome you all to the Wiltshire Creative's 2021 Connections Festival. They're welcoming groups from across Salisbury and the surrounding areas. I'm really excited to see what they've been working on. Connections is the National Theatre's nationwide youth theatre programme. We strive to commission writers to create plays written specifically for young people to perform on professional stages across the UK. These plays put young people and their experiences centre stage. And in a year where we've all been incredibly isolated, they have allowed the participants to connect imaginatively to different worlds and ideas. Despite the global pandemic and the closure of schools and theatres, it has been incredible to see the hard work and dedication and passion that these young people, their teachers, and the youth theatre leaders have put into creating performances you are going to see throughout this festival. I hope you enjoy them, and I look forward to welcoming you back into the theatre in person very soon.
Hello, universe.
What's going on? We're looking at the stars now. Right? This is what we do after we dance. Okay. They always after we dance.
Right. Can you see them?
No, I don't see any stars.
Shame. You were right, Captain.
Give her a chance.
Look up. What?
Up there. This is the part that fills us with hope.
Part that makes it all worthwhile. They're beautiful, aren't they? I don't see any stars.
Time for you to go, I think.
You didn't see them at first, Jordan.
It takes time.
Just give it some time.
This is stupid.
Perhaps it's time for you to go then, yeah?
No, I don't want to go yet.
And why is that?
I just don't want to go home yet.
Just give it some time. Stars will appear.
Oh, you know there were sweets that you swallowed, right? Sherbet flying saucers.
It doesn't matter what they are.
Just as long as we all look up and give it some time, it doesn't matter what they are.
Right.
As long as we're together.
You don't see them, do you?
Just shut up, right? Shut up.
If you came here through a red door, you could spot a helicopter 1,000 miles away. You can see through the facade and the commonplace. And then you can see it crash and burn. But only if you came here through a red door.
I hate you.
Just give it some time. Took me a while.
Lights from the building, they're actual stars.
They really are.
How?
We don't
know.
They just appear.
They help us see stuff.
Too much stuff sometimes. So, this is what you do. I mean, don't take it the wrong way, but all this fuss about breaking into buildings and looking at stars, eating sherbet flying saucers, I mean, it's sweet that you're doing this together, but why?
Jack?
Someone else tell her. No, you listen to me now anyway.
What's wrong with you?
Nothing is wrong with me. Get on with it.
We do the stuff we do because we're fed up with everything out there.
So this is what you do instead? We break even for the buzz it gives us. We create rules because we have, and we find them rules because we believe in them. We eat sherbet flying saucers because they taste good. And we dance because Tarzan's in all of us.
And the stars?
Well, they're the reward for taking the risk in the first place.
And welcome to season 5 of Find a Partner, where your life depends on the power of love. Who will win at love, who will lose, and who will conquer? Time to find out. Go love!
Your name and character?
My name is Latavo and I play the character of Jess.
My name is Jamie and I portray the character of Jacob.
Hi, I'm Jess and I'm playing the role of Hayley.
Hi, my name's Jesse and I play Sam M, Boy 3 and Andy.
My name is Ethan and I'm playing Spectator 2.
My name is Callum and my character's name is Max.
Hi, my name is Hassan and I play the role of Spectator 1.
Hi, my name's Kaisha and I'm going to be playing Ella.
What do you think?
My name is Millie and I play Sam F.
What do you think of this character?
I think she's typically got trust issues. I feel like she's had them from young. So her views and everything is completely different to everybody else within love and everything.
He's a bit arrogant, but he's quite a funny character.
Character.
I think of him as kind of like a confident as he's like somewhat in his own ways, like he knows a lot of stuff and he's just curious of how to find love and try to get into relationships and such.
I think Hayley's very boy obsessed. She's very sassy. She likes what she gets. She likes to know what she wants.
I would say Sam M is a quite confident guy. He's very, very like macho man and he pretends to be someone he's not, and I think that's quite interesting. Andy is a very, he's a genuine nice guy, cares about his friends and other people, and actually shows interest in people. And then Boy 3 is a very insecure guy who's obviously been messed around a little bit and just doesn't know what to do when it comes to love.
He's definitely less experienced than the other spectator, but as the game show goes along, he becomes just like him, really.
I think she's quite similar to me, yet different. She knows what she wants, mature. If she likes it, she likes it. If she doesn't, that's that.
I think she's a very headstrong woman. I think she knows what she wants. However, I think when two men start kind of fighting for her, I think her head gets quite confused. But I think really she is there to find love but also stand up for herself.
What do you think of the play?
It's new and nothing like I've seen before.
Take away from this play?
People's intentions and what love can really be like.
What do you think of the play?
It's very interesting. I mean, love and death. It's not usual, you know, it's not your typical play or game show or love competition, so that's very interesting.
What do you want the audience to take away from this play?
In a metaphorical sense, how society views love and thinking about that, but physically don't take anything that's theft, you shouldn't do that.
What do you think of the play?
I think it's a really interesting concept. Like, it's so dystopian and it's like a cross between The Hunger Games and Love Island, and it's something that is never seen before, and I think it will really shock audiences when they see it.
I think it's a nice play. Bit cliche, but you know, you move.
What do you think of the play?
I think it's quite an interesting one, actually. I think it's like a bit of a mixture of real life or reality TV, but I would simply call it as a bit of both.
To see, like, love is not always what it's supposed to be. It may look something else on the outside, but then on the inside, it's also something else, you know, so.
Brilliant. What do you think of the play?
This play is really interesting. It's very different from the plays I've seen or looked at before. It's about love, and obviously that's very common. But what the strange thing is it has a lot of death in it, and it's most people would describe it as Love Island meets Hunger Games, and that's pretty interesting.
I think the play is an unusual play. It's not like the typical love. There's death towards it.
I think this character is very flamboyant, toxic, and very judgmental. And, you know, he does this play because he wants to entertain his viewers in the most extreme ways.
What do you want the audience to take away from this play?
I want them to see, like, this dystopian world that we've created and how we've created it using special effects and lighting, and how it can really affect the audience by their feelings with the character. What do you think of the play?
I think this play shows the realities of love. It also exposes the toxic reality of reality television. And yeah.
Thank you.
classmates, teammates, friends, but who are acting differently, dressed differently, just being different.
And so we're all split into us and them. Who are you?
We asked us.
What is going on?
No, you
tell us.
We don't know. Excuse me. The ground didn't open up.
The sky opened up.
The ground.
The sky.
Is anyone's phone
broken? There's no dollar signs or Wi-Fi or anything.
great.
Me? Toilet?
Sorry you don't like the way we smell.
I didn't say that. I'm sorry about him. He's in a mood.
Why?
Because I didn't say I love him back.
Why didn't you say it?
Because I don't. I love my baby and he's not his. He may look and sound the same, but I'm not his Sam. I'm sorry about what happened to her, but it's not my fault. It's not our fault.
What?
Mr. Johnson's taking small groups of us to the canteen to get snacks, so I saved your spot in the first group.
Are you coming, thank you?
I only stayed for one space.
Boy.
Really stupid, but COVID is going to be hard and just get sucked back up by the universe.
You can't go outside.
sure. There's a tear happening here. There could be tears all over, we could be morphing and shifting around. You could go back up into a universe where the dinosaurs never got wiped out, or one that's completely submerged in water.
Or we could end up back home.
You willing to take a risk? Who's to say our people might try to jump now? They could end up in a completely different universe. Let's all just wait until the mercy comes out, okay?
You don't know me, because I'm not. She said that. Sam, she said. It's not my problem. I just wanted it to not be my problem for a minute, just so I could have a break.
Yeah, she's lying, she's one of them.
I'm not. Please.
Hey, come on, hear what I say. I'm staying with Sam.
Okay, we should go.
Get out of my way.
You can't leave. You might have it. I'm sorry.
I don't.
You might.
I can't let her die again. Just let her through. Other ones do. You can't just sit here and do nothing.
He's right. We have to do something.
But what?
Think Alex is all so clever. Comes on orange for the first time. Where is it? Can I see it? So, what do oranges have? Vitamin C. And what does vitamin C do?
Fights infections.
Yes. Go to the kitchen, look for anything full of vitamin C. Broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cauliflower, oranges, anything. Jay, I'm going to need you to tell me this. Right. Let's go back to the start. What do we know for sure? Or people who give us care.
Or people who aren't here at all.
That's right, yes.
I tried something. I didn't.
Tried the text it.
I tried the daily.
Scribble on the science book.
School didn't.
Mom and my dad. Dad got someone else.
And so on. Different outcomes from different choices.
But the choices we didn't make happen in a different universe. Completely different. Time and space.
Okay, so how does that help us now?
We can't undo the choices we've made. It's not what we did that matters. It's what we do now. And that can't be us sitting here just glaring at each other.
He's right. It needs to be with us.
Together. All of us together.
Yeah, we're all working together. That's what I just said.
No, I mean, all of us together. A human chain.
Explain.
We create a human chain, long enough to go through the 10.
I said that earlier.
Yes, but if the human chain can get attached to you, then it's like about a uniform, about a universe. We're all going to be back.
Thank you.
comes back where it started, apart from, please don't go. No, you don't, you can stay here with you. We can start a family together.
I have to go back to my mum, my Billy.
I'm your Billy.
No, you know you're not.
I just want my son back. Just like that, everything went back to normal. Apart from that,
yeah. I think about Michael all the time. If she's okay. If I'll ever see her again. Will I ever see her again? If this will happen again.
The official report was that it was some kind of freak weather phenomenon.